In case you found that somebody has taken your YouTube video and then re-uploaded through their YouTube channel, YouTube does a good job these days of giving us a notification within our YouTube channel that somebody has done that. When we click on the notification, it takes us to your creator studio, wherein we can do a removal request. And in the recent past, YouTube has made it even more simpler to fill that removal request form so that you don't take much time in filling these infringing videos to be taken down and send a notice to the person who has taken your video and re-uploaded to their channel. So let's see how to fill that form right now. So these days we can see a notification within our YouTube channel which says new copyright matches found, review videos that may be using your content. Clicking on that will take us to our YouTube studio, creator studio, directly to the copyright section. And I have already removed my video, so that's why it is not showing up under the matches section. But for you, whenever you start coming to your channel copyright section, you will see the infringing video showing up under the matches tab. Since mine is already removed, I'm going to show you how it looks when I got that notification. And we'll also go over how to fill that form which YouTube has given us. Alright, so this was the video and I had taken that down. It has been now resolved. So in your case, this will show up under the matches column. In my case, since it is already removed, I'll not be able to open this particular form, but then I can at least show you how the form looks like so that you can do that on your own. So this is how the form looks like. On the first step, you will find both the videos, the one that you own, that you have created, and the video which somebody else has taken up and then uploaded to their channel. You will also see a link to those two videos, yours and then the others that they have copied. And also sometimes their YouTube channel link, the channel name as well. So in this case, it is showing zero because I have taken a new form for this demo purpose. However, in your case, it will show you the videos that you have requested for removal under this first step. And this section is the copyright owner section, and it's very important for you to fill all the required details. The affected party is myself. In case you are a company or an organization, or if it is for your client, you can choose other option here. But mostly if it is you, the creator, then choose myself, which will be the default option. And then the name of the copyright owner, I am going to fill in my full name here. And then the phone, my own phone number here, which is a required field. You'll have to fill it over here. And then the primary email, the email that you have logged into. So that goes in here for the communication purpose. In case you have a secondary email, you can put that in here. If it is like, for example, if it's your client, maybe you can choose that as well. Next, relationship to copyrighted content. So in this case, I usually type in content creator or I am the creator or something like that, so that you can let YouTube know that what is the relationship to the copyrighted content. So I usually fill in this as content creator, or just say creator. Choose your country and then your address. And then the third field, it's about how do you want this removal timing to happen for the targeted video. I usually go for the standard removal, which is the request removal now, because sending a 7-day notice, usually YouTube gives the uploader 7 days to remove the video and avoid a copyright strike. If they don't, the video is removed after 7 days. So this is based on how you want to do it, but it's totally your choice. However, I usually go for a request removal now because I do not want to give any time, because if you look at it this way, the person who took your video and re-uploaded to their channel, what is the actual motive there? Why does that person have to steal or take somebody else's creation and then re-upload it to their channel? I don't see anything happening here in good faith, because since your video is already there on YouTube, people can search and then watch it. And you, the creator, gets the likes and then watch time and all that stuff. But why does that other person should do that? Doesn't make any sense, right? So that's why I always go for standard request removal, which mostly can lead to a copyright strike. But then that's the risk that the person has taken, right? So I would go for request removal now, which is a standard request, so that the request can happen within hours rather than giving them a 7-day notice. So I would choose standard option here, and then and here is the new option that YouTube has come up with. Check this box. I would suggest to check this box, which says that which will prevent further copies being appearing on YouTube going forward. And this they do, I think, maybe with some content matching algorithm that they have. And if the takedown request is valid, which in most cases will be, YouTube will make its best effort to prevent new uploads from appearing on the platform. So I would highly recommend checking this box so that the same video doesn't get into copyright issues, so that you need not spend time on doing this stuff. And then check this box because you certify YouTube that you have this worldwide exclusive rights to the content which you have created. So it's a good option. Make sure you check these as well. And finally, the legal agreements. I would suggest just check all these options. These are all legally required fields, and it just says that you have a good faith belief that the use of the material in the manner complained is not authorized by the copyright owner, its agent, or the law, and the information in this notification is accurate, and I understand abuse of this tool, like, so you understand the legalese text here. Make sure you check all these boxes, and then write in your name. Your signature should contain your full legal name, which is usually your first name and then the last name, or your surname as stated on your government issued ID. YouTube, they also say that YouTube cannot process the request without this info. So make sure you put in your name here as per your government ID. Right? So that's it. Once you're done with all these, go ahead and then submit your request removal form. Once this is done, you will get a notification from YouTube copyright complaint submission stating that thank you for submitting the takedown request, and your request will be reviewed to make sure it's valid. And once this is complete, you'll get another email which says that thank you very much for your notification and the content has been removed. You can see that the timing differences between here, the first and the second email, the time it took between the copyright infringement submission and then the takedown happening, it's just a few hours. On the same day, at around midnight 12:42, I submitted it, and then by 1:21 YouTube has taken down that video. And once it has been taken out, you can see that the infringed video is also removed. The person who has copied my video, that URL says that the video is unavailable and the video is no longer available due to a copyright claim by me, PB Anusarthi. So that's how it works. I hope you never get into this situation, but in case you do, now you know how to complete your video request removal form in YouTube Creator Studio. Thanks for watching.